Hello, this lecture is dedicated to the IFIM methodology and the physical habitat simulation technique. I will start with an introduction, then I will explain the process of the in-stream flow incremental methodology, IFIM, then the general process of the physical habitat simulation, and a summary. To introduce the topic, I have to tell that the in-stream flow incremental methodology started in the 70s and it was the first general methodological framework for environmental flows, integrating modeling techniques and negotiation. And it's based on the incrementalism. That means that it's a style of decision making in which the position of the stakeholders change gradually or stepwise towards the final solution. And in that process, the stakeholders or the interdisciplinary team, they have to take into account different analyses like the legal and institutional framework, the hydraulics, hydrology, habitat simulation, the evaluation of alternative scenarios of water management, as you will see later on. And of course, different libraries for computers were developed in that time, and now different tools are available for the different steps. The IFIM was, for different reasons, the most frequently used method for decades in the field of environmental flows. So here is the first illustration of the process of IFIM, and there are five phases in IFIM. First, of course, an interdisciplinary group should be formed, or interagency group. And then the first phase is the problem identification. That means there will be a legal and institutional analysis and a physical analysis of the frame of the project to be developed. And after that, there's a second phase of study planning where the participants, the group, will define precisely the objectives, the outreach, the budget of all the studies, like modeling, for example, that they want to be developed in the process. Then the outcome will be the study objectives to perform the third phase, or study implementation, where here you can see first, some analysis or modeling concerning the macrohabitat species suitability if there are models of this kind, like mesohabitat, or can be also included, or macrohabitat. Then there can be temperature model, and then water quality models. The other part of the study implementation usually includes the microhabitat species or microhabitat simulation, where we need to consider several factors or components that I will explain later on. After this implementation of modeling tools and techniques, all this information is coupled with hydrology to perform or to obtain what we call the total usable habitat time series and effective habitat over time for one or several target species. With this information, there can be performed one alternative analysis of the different alternatives for water management and environmental flows. And finally, the last phase will be the problem resolution. But there can be a feedback into the methodology, as you can see here in the plot, if some of the models should be refined, or the uncertainty should be reduced, or some other things should be developed. And of course, after problem resolution, the monitoring and evaluation is highly recommended to facilitate the adaptive management of the water resources. So it's very important to consider that after the decision of environmental flows, the monitoring and evaluation is very relevant. Therefore, the physical habitat simulation technique was created as a fundamental part of the study implementation of IFIM. Then some software tools were created, like in that time PHAPSIM, but other tools are available today. So you can use numerous tools or models that can be combined to simulate different aspects of riverine habitats. For example, the SIFA is the System for Environmental Flow Analysis, one of the software tools that can be used today. Then the physical habitat simulation requires some steps that I'm going to show and fundamental components. First, a hydraulic model of the representative ridge selected for the study, or several, and then the habitat suitability models, usually at microhabitat scale, that you've seen in other lectures, and they should be selected for the target aquatic organisms and the river types where you are working. Then, of course, the simulation can produce some results to feed the alternatives analysis where hydrological data will be necessary. But now we're going to see the process of the physical habitat simulation itself in basically three steps. First of all, is the hydraulic simulation, where here you can see the plot or the plan view of a 1D model, one-dimensional model, and the right-hand view from a two-dimensional hydraulic model. In both of them, there are some minimal or basic units of the model in the calculation, and in each of these cells or elements, the hydraulic model is going to give us the velocity, depth, and other potential attributes like substrate for each of the stream or river flow rate calculated or simulated. Right, so for each of these units in the model that here are plotted like an orange piece, then for each of them we can calculate, based on the habitat suitability models, what we call the suitability index that you've seen in previous lectures. Here, for example, is the example for a target species 1, and this is a habitat suitability curve for depth. So this is the simplest model we can do to calculate suitability from the value of a variable, from the values that we can see of the variable in a river. Here, for example, for depth, we can calculate, or we can go to the curve and obtain a suitability index of 0.9. This is suitability for depth. And we could do the same for the target species 1 for the other variables like velocity and substrate. And these are very simplistic models, but of course we could show other different habitat suitability models made with machine learning techniques or other statistical complex methods. But the final, or the final output here in this step is that we obtain the suitability index for each of the variables considered. From these indices combined with the area of all these pieces of the model, we can calculate for one river flow rate the value that we call weighted usable area, or area weighted suitability. Here we see that in this plot there is a black line, a higher line for the target species 1, and for the flow 1.346 we could see one of these points. However, for different flows, the hydraulic simulation is going to give us all these results of the variables, and we can calculate the variation of this weighted usable area with a river flow rate. And if we have different habitat suitability models for different species, we can calculate other curves, like you can see in the plot, for target species too or others. And different other methods or regulations or legal norms in different countries, some of them regulate how we can combine this information to get a minimum flow or high flow or whatever. And the last step is this, the generation of these curves, but in the IFIM framework we can feed other processes like the habitat time series. We can calculate the alternative scenarios of environmental flows, or to explain better, we can estimate the habitat values or weighted usable area in different alternative scenarios. We can analyze the habitat and its distribution in the river, for example, based on two-dimensional hydraulic models. And for example, we can combine this information with temperature models that will tell us if the habitat in terms of depth and velocity and temperature are able to provide suitable habitat for some species, for example, under situations or scenarios of climate change. Finally, as a very brief summary, I can tell that the IFIM was created to give support in decision making when the evaluation of the impacts of a project on the river ecosystem is necessary. So, IFIM facilitates the communication between different professionals and stakeholders. But it was not created to give a number, because the solution is achieved after negotiation based on scientific information and technical studies, but there's nothing such as the mathematical solution or the final number of the method. And finally, I want to tell that it's important to distinguish the general framework of IFIM from the technique of the physical habitat simulation that can be used independently and in fact is very extended worldwide. And it's important to remember that different scales and different ecological factors should be considered in this habitat simulation, such as microhabitat, water temperature, chemical quality, etc. And this is the end of the lecture.